Hi everybody, I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me. There was a 6.3 earthquake off the coast of Chile near Constitution. The buoys are going off, so there should be a tsunami warning. Here you can see we got two buoys going off. More likely this was a mega thrust earthquake. Let's take a look at this one here. And let me bring this up. All right. Yep. Not good. Okay, let's go back to this one here. Okay. Yeah, there's probably the initial earthquake right there that created the tsunami. Tsunami.gov said there is no tsunami warning, advisory, or watch. They don't even have this earthquake down here listed. See that? Let me bring this down. This event off of Eureka, California. Now that was back on the 21st. And then this one here, Big Island of Hawaii. Yeah, that was on the 26th. Wouldn't be the first time they didn't issue a tsunami warning and it came later. Here you can see it was a thrust earthquake. That's where one side of the fault rises up. And the other one usually stays stationary. Looks like, it went north, a little bit northwest. Yeah, and it rose up here. See that? It shook up Yellowstone. Not surprising. Let's bring this down. Down here at the bottom is the promontory. That's, what I've been talking about, how I was going to download the data there for Yellowstone Lake. And then we got Mary Lake above it and the borehole for Yellowstone Lake. See how it really shook up the promontory? The reason this happened is we got this trench, the Nazca plate, going underneath the South American plate. Back in 2010, there was a magnitude 8.8, I believe it was. Let's see. January 27th, and that was along what they call the Chile Trench. Here is the felt report sent into EMSC, hard enough. Now that was Concepcion, Chile, 126 kilometers south, so that would be about 78 miles. Another one a little bit farther south. It was a smooth movement, but it took off. Let's see, long movement, strong real estate, moved a lot, felt a short and long. These are all Concepcion. Let's see, just undulating motion, no noise, no falling objects, very busy on the 12th floor, CCP. Okay, quite a movement, lasted a long time. If I were walking in the sea, yeah, up and down motion probably. Long underground sound. San Pedro La Paz, Chile. All right, San Pedro, super smooth in San Pedro de La Paz region, in a circular shape. That's probably what it felt like. Prior to the tremor, a loud sound was heard, like the plane flying low, then smooth movement. That would have been the P wave, the first wave of the earthquake. Prior to the tremor, boy, am I all tied here. A loud sound was heard, like a plane flying low. Okay. Huh. Okay, long movement. It was felt for a few seconds, no more than 10. The pendulum lamps made the tenecuric movement noticeable. Probably pronounced that wrong. Oscillating and sustained. Felt in Los Angeles, Chile. light. Movement like a smooth and strong boat at the same time. Felt a balance. Soft sway. Short and mild movement. Earthquake in San Miguel. Santiago, Chile. 332 kilometers northeast. So that would be about 206 miles. Another one said it was soft. And the last one they got. It's not translating. Sending prayers. Yeah, if you see the water going out, you should know that it's going to come back in. And it's not always just one wave. It's like ripples in a pond. Yeah, multiple waves that would be coming in. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.